Hello team, I'm going to show you how to change from Bitcoin only firmware to universal firmware for other coins on your Trezor. And I've finally solved it after mucking around for a while. I feel like I've cracked the code because I really couldn't find the answer. So everywhere I looked told me to go to settings, application, scroll down, and then device and scroll down, and then over here where it says firmware type, there should have been a button here called universal firmware, right? So every kind of help article that I found told me to do that, something like this. It's not there, and it took me a while to figure this out, so I thought I'd make this video and hopefully it helps a few of you out. So the way to do it is, so go to your settings, device, scroll down, and go to your section here called danger area. Okay, here we go. Install custom firmware. You want to click on the install firmware button. Now here, it's going to tell you to select compatible firmware with a link to their GitHub where you can download it directly from them. Now it's very important that you download it directly from the official Trezor GitHub and nowhere else. So let's click on that link. Now I've got a Trezor 3, so where it takes you may be a little bit different. So just be wary of that. But if I just go back a sec and just check which firmware I'm on, okay? I'm on 2. Actually, it's just upgraded me. Yesterday it was 2.8.0. So I hope this works. So back in that link, you'll see their different versions. You'll see 2.8.7 Bitcoin only. That's the one that I supposedly have installed. The one I want is this one here. So I'll click on that. Now, if your version is different, maybe just select the appropriate one. We're then going to click on this download button, download the raw file. Okay. Back to where the danger area was, install firmware, and we're going to drag and drop that file that we just downloaded from the official Trezor GitHub into that box. So and install. Now, really importantly, do you have your seed words backed up offline? Because this update will probably, in my experience, reset your entire device. So make sure that you've got your seed phrase, otherwise you do not have access to your funds. If you're unsure, please do not proceed until you are absolutely sure. Okay, now it's going to, on your device, ask you to enter your PIN. Let's restart and then click install firmware. And this should start the process to go from the Bitcoin only to the universal. One more thing here. Okay. Yep. Everything will be erased. Install. Okay. That should take a couple of minutes. All done, device is restarting. All right, so there we go. You can see now that the type of firmware installed is universal, and you can in the future switch back to Bitcoin only if you need. You will have to set up your Trezor again from the start, and enter your seed phrase. So firmware is ready. Yep, it's going to check your device is authentic again. Good. Okay. There you go. So you've now got the option of creating a brand new wallet if you haven't done so before, or recovering your existing wallet. Hopefully that shows you how you can easily install the universal firmware on the Trezor device. If you've got any questions, please don't hesitate to ask, and please like and subscribe. Thanks.